Friends, here our concept is introduction to curl command. See, this curl command is a command line tool, and by using this curl command, we can receive and send data between a client and server or any two machines which are connected over the internet. And here in our case, we are using curl command to download files like image file or any software or the content of a website. And also we will see how to execute REST APIs using curl command. And in this present video, we will see how to use curl command to download files. Anyway, our main concept is executing REST APIs using curl command, that we'll discuss in our later videos. And curl command supports wide range of protocols like HTTP, HTTPS, FTP, IMAP, LDAP, POP3, SMTP, and many more. And this curl command is the default command on all latest operating systems. You can verify this curl command on your operating system by opening your command line and by typing curl space hyphen hyphen version. Let me open my Windows terminal. So here simply I am verifying curl command. Yes, it is there. Now let me open my Ubuntu. So here also I am verifying my curl command. That's it. Fine. Now let me show you the basic usage of curl command. See, the basic syntax of curl command is simply curl some URL. Let me type that. Simply I am typing curl space, suppose www.google.com. See that you are getting a output. I mean, your curl command is downloading the content from your website as HTML. If it is a website, it will download the content of that website as a HTML file. You can verify this even on your Windows also. Simply curl. Or let me take one more website. Suppose www.curl.example.com. See that this is the HTML content. You are downloading the website content directly as a HTML content. Now, if you want to store this HTML content into a file, because this is not a file content, it is the website content directly. Now, if you want to store this into a file, yes, you can use simply curl hyphen o option, or both are valid, hyphen hyphen output. Suppose I am downloading this as example.html, then just provide your URL. That's it. Now your content has been downloaded into example.html file. Observe that. Now you can verify the content in that. So I am on Windows operating system. I am using type command to see. HTML. See that? Right? So you can use curl hyphen hyphen output, or simply hyphen o. Let me take new example.html. So now our content has been downloaded into new example.html file. You can verify the files. Now it is there. Fine. So this is the way how we can download a website content into a file. Now let me download any software using curl command. Let me open my browser first. So I am trying to download some Tomcat. Let's say Tomcat download. Just open official website and go to any one of the Tomcat version under download. I am downloading suppose Tomcat 9. And here just select suppose Windows 64 bit or anything. Now it is downloading directly. Just click on OK and then just try to cancel that. Now right click on the cancelled file and copy download link. Now try to download that using curl command. So simply I am using curl space your URL and observe the output. Binary output can mess up your terminal. So use hyphen hyphen output to tell, I mean, in which file you want to save your content. So we know an option for your curl command, that is simply hyphen o. I am taking tomcat9.zip. That's it. Now observe the output. It is downloading your Tomcat using curl command, and the software is downloading into this file. Now see that content. It is there here, tomcat9.zip. Now without any option, if you try to download your software, it is giving some warning and it is stopping, right? In case, if you want to download the software with the same name, whatever you have, if you don't want to mention your file name, and if you want to download the software with the same name, whatever it is there in the link, it is the Tomcat, Apache Tomcat 9.0.31 Windows 64.zip, right? With that file name, in case if you want to download, then for that also we have a option called curl hyphen capital O. So previously we use small o, now capital O. Then just provide your link. Now see that it is downloading. And once it is downloaded, you can see the downloaded file name as same thing, same as this one. So once it is downloaded, then we can verify that. Yeah, downloaded, right? Just see that. This is the one we downloaded, right? So be clear on small hyphen O and small capital hyphen O, right? So this is the basic usage of your curl command. Okay, guys, thank you for watching this video.